cable suspension bridges sensing heat shifting girders. Okay, so we have in last class. Some disturbance I am observing. Just a bit. Okay, so last class we have studied the cables and the suspension bridges. We have studied the introduction part. Okay. So here, introduction, we have studied that in suspension bridges, you know, so this introduction about this particular part we have seen, that how the cables, you know, the cables and the anchor cables, what are their functions, then how are the roadways, the vertical members, we call them as tower, and there is a span. Okay, when and this particular part is reverb. So the how overall, you know, how it is all formed, the overall overlook of this suspension cable. Okay, so we have also studied the problem when there was one single point load acting. Okay, so we have solved a problem where one point load was acting on the cable. And we have seen what is the, you know, what is the deflection Y1, Y2, Y3. So we have calculated that. And we have also seen how the anchor cables, suspension cables, means that is a part of guided pulley support and even roller pulley support. How is the functioning of stiffening girder. So this is all basics we have covered in our last class. Okay. Okay. So now, what we are going to do? We are going to study when these supports are not at the same level. Okay. So we are going to see that now. Okay, so let's start with this particular problem. A cable of span 100 meter has its ends at heights 8 meter and 15 meter above the lowest point of the cable. It carries a UDL of 10 kN per meter per unit horizontal run of the span. Determine the horizontal and vertical reactions at the support and what is the length of the cable. Okay, so this is how we are going to consider this problem. But before we solve this problem, let us make ourselves know what is that formulation we are going to use, what are the formulas and what are the steps to solve such problem. Okay, so cables with ends at different level. Okay, for such case, when this is a case, you can say a standard case, you know. So this height is H1 and this height is H2 and this is, we can see, okay, C is a point. So from this point, the left support is at L1 and the right support is at L2, okay. So like in arch, we consider a C point as a hinge, right. So here, let us consider the C point as a lowest point here. Okay, so C is the lowest point in the particular here at this depth, and the distance H2 and H1 is given from the support. Okay, now how do we calculate the L1 and L2? Okay, what is the length for L1 and L2? So that is, so L1 is equal to L So these formulations are important, which you should know. H1 divided by root of H1 plus root of H2. Okay, so this is one important formula you should remember. And there is other formula, when you want to calculate what is the length L2, then it is L into root of H2 by root of H1 plus root of H2. Okay, so these two formulas, with this we will get what is the length at L1 and L2. Okay, now we also need to find out what are the reactions. Okay, what is the VA and VB? So for VA and VB, VA is equal to the load. We know the load here. If you see this diagram carefully, anyways, we are going to solve this problem. But before that, I am just discussing the formulas. So in this particular question, it is given that a cable of span 100 meter has its ends at height 8 meter and 15 meter. Okay, so two heights it is given above the lowest point of the cable, and it carries a UDL. So this is what the UDL. Okay, so W per unit length. So that UDL is given here. Okay, so that will come when we are calculating reactions. So VA will be W into L1 by 2 plus H1 by L1 into H. Okay, so this is a formula for VA, and there is VB, W into L2 by 2 plus H2 by L2 into H. Okay, so these are the four important formulas you should know. And we will calculate the horizontal reaction. Okay, what is H? So that H is equal to then H formula will be, let me just write it here. H is equal to
H formula will be
W L square divided by 2 into root of H1 plus root of H2 the whole square. So students, whenever there is just now I saw voice sound is not good. Okay, let me just check. Okay, let me check if there is some issue with sound. Just kindly wait. Kindly give me 2-3 minutes. I will just restart the system. Hello. Okay, kindly respond students if I am audible. Hello students, hope I am audible now. Okay students, I assume that I am audible now. Okay, and I am starting with the our topic. So what I said that in our last class we have started with this topic, cable suspension bridges and three hinge stiffening girder. Okay, so we know the basics of it, and we have also solved a problem when point load is acting on a per unit length, you can see here. Now then, determine the horizontal and vertical reactions at support and what is the length of the cable. Okay, so that is what we have to see. Okay, now the screen is visible. Okay, so here L1. So when we want to calculate what is the distance from the support to the central dip. Okay, so what is the distance L1? So L1 is calculated as L, okay, the total length L into root of H1, okay, so this length H1 plus divided by root of H1 plus root of H2, okay, so that is how we calculate the length L1. Then there is a formula for L2. So L2 is equal to L into root of H2 by root of H1 plus root of H2. Okay, so this is our L2 length. Then there is the reactions at support. So VA and VB. So VA and VB, we calculate with this formula. So W, this W is a UDL what we take. Okay, so W into L1. So this W, it is acting in this particular span. Okay. In this particular span, what W is acting? So W into L1 by 2, the plus H1 by L1, okay, H1 by L1 into the high into H, okay, the horizontal reaction over here, and VB is equal to WL2 by 2 plus H2 by L2 into H. And H we calculate as WL square 2 into root of H1 plus H2. So you need to know all the five formulas to get our answers. So here we have to calculate, we have to determine the horizontal and vertical reactions at supports. And also we need to calculate what is the length of the cable. Okay, so let's start solving this problem. Okay, let me just. Now, let us start solving it. So here we can see that, let us write down all the data, okay? So the two values what is given, that is H1. So H1 is equal to, H1 is given as 8 meter and H2 is given as 15 meter. Okay, and the total span L is given as 100 meter. Okay, now this is for L1 and L2 here. So let us consider moment about A and B. Okay, so let us consider moment about A and B. So we will consider this is support A. Let me just name it. Let us consider the support A and B. Okay, so moment about A and B. When we calculate it from the midsection, okay? So when we calculate from the midsection, so how we will write? So let us, so this line, this when we just, you know, try and separate it, we'll just try to draw a free body diagram before we write this equation. So I'm just drawing a free body diagram. So here, let us separate it at point C. So this is half one part of the cable, till the L1 part. Okay, now let's draw the L2 part beside this. So L2 part will be like this. Now here it is not at the same level, right? So as per the question, I'm just trying to draw a free body diagram. Okay, so this is just a free body diagram. Kindly excuse for the diagram. Okay, so some slight variation is there, but it is the free body diagram for the same picture. So this is VB and this is the horizontal reaction. This is the VB, this is B support, and here it is H, horizontal reaction. And then there is vertical reaction. Now, H1, okay, H1, let us show it here so that for the clarity. So this is actually 8 meter from the central dip. If you see the center here, C means the lowest point, okay? And the H2, if you can see the other height, let me draw a line here from this support. So this particular length, it is 15 meter. So let's draw it. This is 15 meter, okay? Now at this point, at this joint, when there is a horizontal reaction, so we can say that, you know, there will be opposite force here. We can show that at this point also we can draw a equilibrium and we can show a horizontal force here. Hi, so I can see few students join. Okay, so this is our horizontal force. Now there is a UDL. Okay, so UDL given is, after this we are also going to solve a Mumbai University question which came in exam. Okay, so for a stiffening girder. So once we'll complete this and then other problems. So two problems we are going to cover in this class. Okay, so this is the free body diagram. And yes, there are these suspenders. Let me just show it quickly. Okay, so here, now we know the H1 is 8 meter, H2 is 15 meter and length is 100 meter. Okay, so let us consider moment. About support A. Okay, so let us write down moment about A. What it will be? What will be the moment about A? Can it carry a moment? What we should write? Moment about A will be 0, right? So the our equation will be, let's see what all forces are available over here. So there are forces when you consider moment about support A. Let me just write here. Okay, this is our support A and this is our support B. So the loads are, we know that there is a UDL available. So UDL here is 10 kilonewton per meter. UDL is available and there is a horizontal reaction. Okay, so we can write when we want to know what is the moment about here, right? Moment about support A we have to calculate. So there is a UDL and to balance this horizontal reaction, there will be one H here, right? So our equation for moment support A, okay, so it will be H into 8, okay, at this point we are considering, okay, H. So H into 8, this 8 meters, and then there is a UDL also. So 10 into, it is acting in the span of L1, okay, this is the L1 span. So 10 into L1. And again, it will act in the middle, okay, CG of it. So it will be L1 by 2 is equal to 0, okay. So this is your one equation. And when you consider the right side part, okay, right side part of the right side of free body diagram. Now when you consider moment about support B, so we can write again here. The H will be there, so, okay, to support this, there will be H will be from this side. So we will write H into, now how much is the height? Okay, total height is 15 and here we can write it as this total length, it is 10 meter. This is 15 meter. In the picture, yeah, it is 15 meter, okay, and this is 8 meter and this is total length as 100 meter span, right? So now here it is L by 2, so we will write H into 15 minus, again 10 length is there, so 10 into L2 into L2 by 2, Okay, so this is our second equation. So we got two equations over here, 1 and 2. Okay, so with this equation, with the first equation, when you simplify it, we can simply write this same equation as 8 into h is equal to 5 into L1 square. Okay, and with the second equation, we can write that 15 into h is equal to, this is 2 ones are 2 and 2 fives are 10. So we can write it as 5 into L2 square. Okay, so this is our equation. Now with this, we get the relation. Okay, we get the relation as L1 square by L2 square is equal to 8 by 15. Okay, if you just take a ratio of it, how we can read L1 square by L2 square equals to 8 by 15. Okay, HH will get cancelled. So this one relation we are getting here. So further we can simplify it as L1 by L2 is equal to root 8 by root 15, which is equal to 0.730. Okay, so let's do this calculation. Root 8 by root 15, okay, so 0.730. So this is the ratio we are getting over here. Okay, now once you get this relation, we can further write it as, further simplify it as, let me just copy, you know, this for the reference. So we have done L1 by L2, we got the ratio as 0.730. So we can write the L1 plus L2. So what is L1 plus L2? It is nothing but the total span. Okay, it is nothing but the total span. So here 0.730, this ratio we got it as L1 by L2 is equal to 0.730. So L1 plus L2 we can write it as 1.730. So L1 we can write again 0.730 by 1.73 into L1 plus L2. So with this, L1 plus L2 we know that it is 100. So just multiply with 100 divided by 1.73. So then you will get answer as 0.730 into 100. So we get the answer as 42.214. 42.214 meter. So this is our L1. Okay. So this is 42.214. Now let us find out what is our L1. You got it. So when L1 is there, just let me check the darkness, little darkness is there. Okay, so L2 is equal to, okay, so L1 is this one and L2, then we'll get it as simply 100 minus 42.214. Okay, so here when you subtract 100 minus 42.214, so we get it as 57.786. Okay, so this is our answer. So we have calculated what is L1 and L2. Now let us find out what is the vertical reaction. So VA, so vertical reaction VA, we will calculate, it is nothing but W into L1. Okay, so whatever UDL is acting into L1, so that is the only vertical reaction. So W is 10 kilo newton per meter load is given into the L1 is 42.214. So our answer is 422.14 kilo newton. Okay, so this is our answer for VA. Okay, so 422.14 kilonewton. Then let us consider the moment about point C. So moment about point C is zero. So how we will calculate moment about point C? So consider the left part. Okay, left part. So left we can write it as 8 into h. Okay, so this total height is 8. So 8 into h. And then there is a UDL we have to consider, okay? So it is 10 into L1 square by 2, okay? Because UDL it is, so 10 into L1 into L1 by 2. So then we will get H is equal to 10 into 42.214 square divided by 8 into 2. Okay, so here 1113.76 kilonewton. Okay, when you calculate H value is 3.76 kilonewton. So this is the answer. Then let's see what is VB. So for VB, we will again use the simple formula W into L by 2, because in this area, if you see, there is no other load but only UDL. So it's nothing but W into L2. Okay. So W into L2. So here W is nothing but 10, and L2 is equal to 57. Right? This length 57.786. So 577.86 kilonewton. Okay, so this is the answer we got. Now, what is the length of cable? So length of cable we can find out with this formula. So you have to remember this formula. L plus 2/3 of H1 square by L1 plus 2/3 of H2 square by L1. So L is 100 plus 2/3, H1 is H square by 42.214 plus 2/3 of H2 value given as 15. 15 square H2 value is given as 15 square divided by 3 into L1. So L1 is how much? 57.786. Okay. So then in this, we get the answer as, when you calculate, do the calculation. So you will get it as 100 plus 64 into 2 divided by 3 divided by 42.214. So here just 1.01. Okay, so our answer is 101.01 meter. So that's not 1.01, there is a slight calculation mistake. It is 3.01. So we get the answer as 103.01 meter. Okay, so length of the cable is 103.01 meter. So this is the problem when the supports, okay, when the supports are not at the same level, okay, when they are not at same level, then we our procedure to find out is like this. Okay, now we are going to see a question about stiffening girder. Okay, stiffening girder. Okay, so let's take a case of it. Suspension bridge. Suspension bridge with three hinged stiffening girder. Three hinged stiffening girder. So what is it? Okay, a typical suspension bridge with three hinged stiffening girder. It looks like this. Okay, so it will look like this. This should be the proper, it should be a smooth curve. And the straight lines. Okay, and it will have A, C, B. It will have some load acting, point load acting. It may or may not have. So, like here, for the example, W1, W2, and W3. This is C, one member, CC dash, a central member. Now, so whenever we consider a suspension cable and it is stiffened with a 3-inch girder, okay, so the girder can be, what is a girder? Girder is nothing but it is a heavy beam, okay, girder is nothing but it is a very heavy beam, okay, or it can also be a truss. So a girder can be a heavy beam or a truss, okay, which has 3 hinges at the ends, okay, it can have 3 hinges at the ends and it can have one hinge at the center. So like 3-inch arch we know, so this is, you know, like opposite curve than when we consider the 3-inch arch. So the cable and the girder, they are connected by number of hangers or suspenders. So these are the vertical lines, they are the, we can call them as a hanger or suspender. Okay, now they are very large. These suspenders are actually very huge. So the load on the cable, because of the forces, you know, we, that's why we consider the load as UDL. We don't consider the load of these suspenders. Okay, these are the suspenders or hangers. They are very huge. So we don't consider their load as a point load, but we consider it as a UDL, uniformly distributed load. Okay, now when we separate this. So if you cut it in between and try to draw the free body diagram of a cable and a girder. So if this is our cable, okay. So when you draw a free body diagram, then the load we consider . So these are the hangers, okay. So we are cutting somewhere here like this. I should use a different. So when you take a free body diagram, okay, and the these same loads, they are acting downward, W1, W2, W3, whatever number of loads,
Okay, so this particular part, you know, so when we consider this is the free body diagram, this is a free body diagram of cable and girder, free body diagram of cable and girder. So in this case, when we consider in this case we consider WE per unit horizontal length. Okay, so this particular suspender load, whatever load I have told you, the suspender load, it cannot be a point load because it is very huge. So we denote it as a WE. Okay, we denote it as with letter W suffix E. So this WE is a load which is acting per unit horizontal length, per unit horizontal length. Okay, so this is the UDL. So WE per unit length. Now when we consider the moment at the central hinge of the girder, so when we consider moment about the central hinge of the girder, so this is the C dash, or we may consider it as here C dash. Okay, so when we consider moment about it, so then this W, the uniformly distributed load exerted by suspenders, can be determined. So where you consider moment about this point, and we can find out what is the unit load. So anyways, we are going to use this procedure to solve our problem. Okay, so this is the basic of how do we consider the free body diagram of it, and how we show the loads. Okay, now let's see a question. So let me just take out the question. Okay, so our question is, so this question came in Mumbai University December 2019. Okay, this question came in Mumbai University December 2019. So write down a question. A question says a suspension bridge of 120 meter, a suspension bridge of 120 meter span. It has two three hinged stiffening girders. Supported by two cables having a central dip of 12 meter and the roadway has width of 6 meter, the roadway has a width of 6 meter, the dead load on the bridge is 5 kilonewton per meter, and the live load is 10 kilonewton per meter square, which acts on the left half of the span. So determine the shear force and bending moment in the girder. Okay, so we are supposed to determine the shear force and bending moment in the girder at 30 meter from the left hand. Find also the maximum tension. In the cable for positive live load. Okay, students, so this is a 10 marks question. It's a 10 marks question, came in December 2019. Okay, so the question is given as a suspension bridge of 120 meter span has three hinged stiffening girders supported by two cables. Okay, supported by two cables having a central dip of 12 meter and the roadway has a width of 6 meter. The dead load on the dead load is 5 kN per meter square and the live load is 10 kN per meter square. And which while the live load is 10 kN per meter square, which acts on the left of the span. So determine the shear force and bending moment in the girder at 30 meter. Okay, in the girder at 30 meter from the left end, and find also the maximum tension in the cable for a positive live load. Okay, so this is the question given. Now quickly see the data what is given and write it down. So width of the bridge is 6 meter. Width is 6 meter and dead load, okay, dead load given on the bridge is 5 kN per meter square. Then how will be the dead load on each girder? Okay, how will be the dead load? So dead load on each girder, dead load on each girder we can find out as 5 into 6 by 2. Okay, so width is 6 and this is 5. So we can find out the dead load on each girder as 5 into 6 by 2. So dead load into width divided by 2. So it is, we get in terms of UDL 15 kN per meter. Similarly, calculate what is the live load. Okay, so live load on the bridge is equal to 10 kN per meter square. Therefore, live load on each girder, so it will be 10 into 6 by 2. So that is 30 kN per meter. Okay, so this is our live load. So we have found out what is the actual live load and dead load. So after this, we are going to use it in calculation. Now let us also show that this is the 12 meter dip is there. Okay, central dip is 12 meter. So that is 12 meter. And here WE per unit length. Right, I told you that this hangers and stiffeners, these suspenders, they are very heavy. So we consider them as a UDL. Okay, now a specification in this problem, you know, that live load and dead load. So that is, you have to be careful. So while considering it, so I'm just showing the load to you. Now see that what it is given. Okay, so the dead load given on each girder, so it is 15 kN per meter. Okay, so I'm showing the dead load here, the dead load what we have calculated. So that is, I'm showing here. So this is your dead load. Okay, and it is 15 kN per meter. Okay, now what it has shown, the live load is acting only on the left of the span. Okay, the live load is acting, what it has shown, In the question, it is saying the live load is 10 kilonewton per meter square, which acts on the left half of the span. So now our live load is 30 kilonewton per meter. So it is on the left. So let us show the live load. So I will use a different color for better understanding. So the live load is this. Okay, so this is live load. And it is 30 kilonewton per meter. Okay, so now we have a dead load and we have a live load also. So these two things are done. Now these loads are shown. Now let the suspender exert a load. Now let the suspenders, okay, these are the suspenders. Now let the suspenders exert a load, EXERT, exert a load W per unit length. Then we have to calculate the reactions, okay. So this is A, this is B. So then we can show the reactions at B. This is a B point. So let's show the reactions. RB here, there will be one reaction here, and there will be one reaction here as well. So this is, let us call it as RB dash, and let us call it as RA dash. Okay, so these are the two reactions. So let RA dash and RB dash, they are the reactions, okay, for the given loadings only, because these loadings what we have considered, so because of that, that is the loading. Now we have to find out what are the reactions. So let us consider the moment about A dash. Okay, let us consider. So this is the support A dash and this is B dash. So let us consider moment about A dash. So what all forces will come? So just see it. So when you consider moment about A dash, so you will have a RB support. So RB dash into total length. So that length is 120. And then there is this UDL. UDL is of 15 kilonewton. That is the UDL because of dead load. And there is a UDL because of live load. Okay, so two UDLs are there. And the total span is 120 meter. So the half span will be 60 meter. So this is 60 meter. This is 60 meter. And the total is 120 meter. Okay, so accordingly our equation will be. So I am just writing here, let us consider moment about A dash is equal to 0. So we can write that RB dash into 120, the load into perpendicular distance. Okay, so RB dash into 120 minus 15, okay, UDL I am taking now. 15 into 120 into 60 minus, okay, 15, this is UDL, so 50 into 160. Into it will be at the CGs, okay, so 60, and then again 30 into 60 into it will be in the half distance, okay, so this is the 30 kilonewton per meter load, it will act in the 60 span and at the middle of it, so 30 into 60 into 30 is equal to 0. So RB dash we get it as 1350 kilonewton. Okay, so this is a reaction at B dash. So what will be RA dash? So RA dash we can find out summation of forces in y direction with the equilibrium equation. So when we do summation of forces in y direction is equal to 0. So RA dash plus RB dash is equal to the 15 kilonewton per meter load, it is a dead load, right? It is acting in all the span 150 meter. And there is this 30 kilonewton load, that is live load, which is acting in the half of the span. So then 15 into 120, so it is 1800 plus 1800. So it will be 3600. Now RB dash we got it as 1350, so RA dash will be 3600 minus 1350, okay, so 3600 minus 1350, so we get it as 2250 kilonewton, okay. So here we have done with the reactions. So we got the reaction. So we got the reaction as Ra dash, that is 20 to 50 kilonewton, and Rb dash is 1350 kilonewton. So these are our answers. Okay, now we have to find out what is the WE. Okay, so this WE we need to calculate. So how do we get going to, how are we going to calculate it? So let us consider moment due to given loading, moment due to given loading plus moment due to W, due to W suffix E is equal to 0. Okay, so whatever moment, because of the given loading, so there are loadings given, right? So what are the loadings? The dead load and the live load. So these two loadings are given here. So whatever moment because of these loadings, so whatever moment because of the given loading and whatever moment with this load, so total should be 0. Okay, so to keep it in equilibrium, so with this we can write the equation as Rb dash, so we are considering Rb dash into 60 minus 15 into 60 into 30 minus WL square by 12, 120 square by 8, sorry. So whatever because of moment due to UDL, what is moment due to UDL? Because of UDL we know the formula WL square by 8, okay, so we have used that formula here. And moment due to given loading, so it is rb dash into 60, okay, rb dash into 60, half of the span, and minus that much UDL, okay, so 15 into 60 whatever acting here and half of it. So when we write this, we know the, we have the answer for rb dash. So let us substitute rb dash value. So rb dash is 1350 into 60 minus 15 into 60 into 30 is equal to WE into 120 square by 8. So with this we get the answer as, yeah, thank you Vasu. So WE we can get it as 30 kilonewton per meter. Okay, so with this we got the what is the uniformly distributed load. Okay, so this is the uniformly distributed load we got. So this, as we said, because it is because of the hangers or stiffening stiffeners. Okay, so that we have got. So once we get WE value, so now let's see what is asked in the question. Okay, so in question it is asked that determine the shear force and bending moment in the girder at 30 meter from the left end. Okay, so we have to calculate what is the shear force and bending moment in the girder at 30 meter from the left support. Okay, so let us write down from 30 meter shear force at 30 meter, from left end, that is what been asked. Okay, that is the question. So what is shear force now? Okay, we have to calculate what is the shear force at 30 meter from the left end. So means 30 meter means if you draw a line, okay, so this is the 30 meter area, the region. So here in this region only we have to find out what is the shear force. So shear force is equal to shear force because of the given loading, okay, and shear force because of the this WE. Okay, so two loads will be there. So shear force due to given loading shear force due to given loading plus shear force due to WE. Okay, so now what is the shear force because of the given loading? So here if you see carefully, when you see the loads in this region, okay, so this is the RA. So RA, it is going up, okay. So RA is going up and there is the live load, there is also a dead load, okay. So this is the bottom portion, as we have seen in the previous slide, it is live load and this is dead load, okay. So these two loads will come and there will be again this UDL. So let us write down RA is, RA dash is going up, this is RA dash, okay, and this is RB dash. So RA dash is going up, then let us consider the UDL. So how much is UDL? So the live load is 15 kilonewton, right? Live load is 30 kilonewton per meter and dead load is 15 kilonewton per meter. So let us write down the dead load is 15 into 30 and minus live load is 30 into 30. Okay, so this is going up, so positive, and it is coming down, so negative. So our sign convention is this is positive. Okay, so when we are doing the calculation this way, so this is positive. Now we have considered the load acting on the span. Now let us consider the WE part. So it is WE by 2 into 30 into 120 minus 30. Okay, so WE acting only in this region. So WE by 2 into 30 and 120 minus 30. So this span is remaining over here. Okay, so when you do the calculation, so RA dash is 2250 here minus 15 into 30 minus 900 minus WE by 2 into 30 into 120. Minus 30. Okay, so then we get, when you do the calculation, our answer is 6750 kilonewton meter. Okay, 6750 kilonewton meter. So this is our shear force. Okay, now when this is our shear force, let us see what is the reaction. Okay, what is the VA? So VA will be, VA is equal to W into L by 2, W E into L by 2. So WE value, WE is for, it is 30 into 120, so for all over the span, divide by 2. So we get the answer as 1800 kilonewton. Okay, now let us find out what is H. So to find out H, let us calculate, let us consider moment about C is equal to 0. Okay, moment about C is equal to 0. So we can write that H into 12. What is 12? 12 is the central dip. Okay, so this was 12 meter. So H into 12 is equal to UDL, WL square by 8. WL square by 8. So WE is 30 into 120 square by 8. So with this we get H is equal to 4500 kilonewton. So once you get the H value, then it's very easy to find out what is the maximum tension. So T max is equal to VA square plus H square. Okay, so VA square, so it is 1800 square plus H is 4500. So when you do the calculation, we get it as 4846.65 kilonewton. Okay, so maximum. So what it is asked, in a find also the maximum tension in the cable for position of live load. Okay, so the maximum tension in the cable is T max. So T max answer, we got it as 4846.65 kilonewton. And if it is asked that what is its inclination to the horizontal, okay, so its inclination to the horizontal so it can be given as T max cos theta is equal to h. Now T max value is given as 4846.65, that's what we got it, into cos theta is equal to 4500. Okay, so with this you do the calculation, 4500 divided by 4846.65. So here you will get the answer theta as 21.80. Okay, so students, these are the this is the solution for a stiffening girder. Okay, so this was the Mumbai University question. So hi Kiran, hi Samir. My class was at 5 o'clock. Okay, so today we have studied a topic here about stiffening girder. Okay, so this was the Mumbai University December 2019 question. It came for the 10 marks. So whenever you get time, just go back and listen to the solution. Okay, so we have solved this question. And here we were asked to calculate what is the tension in the cable, and we were asked to calculate what is the shear force and bending moment, okay, at the girder, and then the tension in the cable. We have also solved one more question. This question we have solved. It's about the when supports are not at the same level. Okay, so we have covered two problems today. So see you on Monday now. So Monday I take structure analysis 2 classes, and Thursday I take for structure analysis 1. Okay, so these two are the days I take classes around 5 o'clock, and for structural analysis 2 current timings are 6, but I am just trying to shift it before, so it's convenient to me. So 5 o'clock I am planning to shift, 5 or 4 o'clock. Okay students, so thank you for listening. Hope you understood this class. Thank you.